right, Marvelous Monty's in the ring. Let's go ahead and bring out his opponent. He is the SLCW Men's Champion. Weighing in at 236 pounds, standing in 100 at a height of 6 feet 2 inches tall. His hometown of Los Angeles, California, he is the man, Michael Thomas! Love him or hate him, Michael Thomas, the current SLCW Men's Champion. He's putting that on the line up here today against Marvelous Monty. A best 2 out of 3 fall.
2 out of 3 falls in this match. There's a bit of about a yo-yo involved. And I mean, I don't claim to judge what men get up to fighting about. Hell, I'll turn like a mother-in-law on somebody when they touch my Mountain Dew. But a yo-yo? Whatever.
Hey. Evidently, it's a very special yo-yo to one of these people, and Michael Thomas has been definitely taunting Marvelous with that yo-yo this entire time. Look, we got the bell rung. We got the two men heading in right off the bat. Immediately, there is action going on, folks. Handlock pin right away. One.
Well, now, you know, in a kind of match like this, if you can rush in and slip one in real quick, that'll put you one up on your opponent. It's not a horribly bad strategy here that they're going for.
And not there's another one. Turn around, another pin. Here we go. One. Pin. Wow, they are going quick. Are we getting it? One.
Now, Michael kicks out of that one. These guys going for broke. Now, if you'll notice, Michael Thomas is usually accompanied to the ring by his valet manager, Beth, and she has been barred, according to the DCWF Championship Committee, she has been barred from ringside here tonight.
Absolutely. Coming off the rope, Michael Thomas scooping him up, slamming him down, pinning him. One, two. Thought we were going to have our first pinfall just then. Michael Thomas with a tough move right there. Marvelous Monty shooting off the ropes. Thomas scooping him up and slamming him down, going for that quick pin. Only got a 2 count though on that one.
And Jose Gomez keeps using different variations of the Spanish word for bitch, and I really don't know what he's saying other than that.
I'm pretty sure he just talked to him a bit.
I don't know who he's talking to or what he's talking about.
I don't know which one he's calling a bitch, but he is definitely calling him a puta.
Now, referee Taylor in this opening match here trying to keep tabs on things. These guys are moving pretty quick, slapping the pins on, the pins on. And let me tell you something about referee Taylor. Referee Aubrey ain't got nothing on referee Taylor, I'm telling you right now.
Referee Taylor, one of the top referees in all of SL, and we are lucky to have her here with us. Michael Thomas is taking it right to Marvelous Monty. Michael Thomas off the rope. Big flip. Lion stop to a pin. One, two, three. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. You got your first pin of the match. Reminder, it is a best 2 out of 3 falls. Michael Thomas scoring that first one early on in the match. Marvelous Monty at a disadvantage already. All right, Taylor making sure the two wrestlers observe the 1 minute ref, like I guess a boxing match. They're going to go ahead, go to their opposite corners and take a little minute to rest up, try to catch their breath before they come out fresh again.
I don't know about anybody being fresh at this point.
Well, evidently Jose Gomez is on Monty's side, telling him, you know, very good, Monty. We'll see how that goes.
He said muy bueno.
All right, Michael Thomas comes charging in. Monty rolling over his back. Thomas slamming into that turnbuckle. Monty up behind him. Monty coming in. Nice move by Monty. The German suplex. Michael Thomas slammed down into the mat. Monty trying to get a little momentum back, trying to take control of this match. Monty flinging Michael Thomas into the corner. Monty following him right in. Elbow smash into the bro hug. And then he starts driving his knees up into Michael Thomas's gut. Michael Thomas pinned in that corner. Taylor trying to get him out. Monty back across. Looks like we got some coast-to-coast action. He comes flying in. Nobody home as Michael Thomas slips out. Monty slamming his foot into that post right there. Can't be a good thing for him.
Now, what the hell is Monty wearing? Did he come in his pajamas?
Monty. Oh, suicide dive. YOLO over the top. Catches Michael Thomas unaware. Michael Thomas not expecting that. Monty with a quick move there. Taylor on the count. Monty is wearing, what is he wearing? Maybe that's his Halloween garb? No, those are pajamas. Those are definitely pajamas, number. I gotta
Might get him in a cup of coffee and in a website connected to Obamacare. He looks like Pajama Boy from the ad. What the hell? Well, whatever, hell, he can walk out of here, the SLCW champion, and who am I to talk shit?
He'll be dressed in those pajamas.
TWF has just been getting more and more impressive every week. If the man wants to wear pajamas, damn it, you should let him wear pajamas.
Monty sending Michael Thomas back into the ring. Monty up on the apron himself. Oh, Thomas going to help him in. Thomas, big monkey flip to bring Marvelous Monty back into the ring. Monty sent flying. Michael Thomas, beautiful move right there. We're gonna celebrate it. Monty up behind him. 1, 2. Michael Thomas doing a little bit too much celebrating right there as Monty was able to get in behind him and almost get that 3 count on that pin, tying this up. Right now, Michael Thomas has the advantage with 1 pin. Marvelous Monty fighting for his life right now. Coming off the ropes, big lariat dragging Michael Thomas down and then picking him back up. Couple of short arm clotheslines right there. 3 of them in a row. That'll make your neck hurt right there.
Well, and this show being brought to you by a replica of what I like to call 2019 Detroit. As you can see, we've got a bunch of rundown buildings here, some ordnance, and a few National Guard soldiers to keep watch over things.
Oh, big come off the ropes, big clap back. He's got the pin. 1, 2, and 3. Marvelous Monty has tied it up. Marvelous Monty flying off the ropes with a huge clap back. He nailed Michael Thomas, got the pin. Now we're all tied up at 1 apiece. Next pinfall wins the match and the SLCW wins.
Well, Monty might figure out a way to slip one by here. He's gonna have to come with it. He's gonna have to put on his game face. Forget about the yo-yos for a second. Once you start making championship kind of money, the yo-yos just kind of, they manifest themselves.
He could probably afford one of them $30 type yo-yos.
I would like to hope so.
Those are the fancy kind. Those are the ones the Smothers Brothers use. Right out of the gate. Minute up. Michael Thomas gets caught by Marvelous Monty as he comes flying in. Pin attempt. 1, 2, and almost had a new SLCW champion right there. Marvelous Monty in his marvelous pajamas laying out Michael Thomas with that big flying clothesline. I guess he calls that a rock bottom.
Well, whatever. Nobody's had that name before. For
Monty throwing Thomas into the ropes. Thomas shooting back. Monty was there waiting. Oh, no! Thomas coming up! The Fujiwara armbar. We got a submission hold in the center of the ring. Are we going to see this end by submission? Michael Thomas has it locked in deep. Monty in a lot of pain. Monty crawling, pulling, straining to get to the edge. Got the ropes. We called for the break. Michael Thomas holding on as long as he wants and then letting it go. Monty able to get the rope, get the break. That was almost a very disappointing turn of events for Monty.
Well, what happens if he breaks his yo-yoing arm? Well, what do you call it? Like, what do you call when you yo-yo? Is it yo-yoing or is it yoing?
I don't know. I've never had the adverb for yo-yo. Yo-yoing? I think yo-yoing sounds good. Marvelous Monty up on the top rope. Michael Thomas caught. Marvelous Monty waiting for him. He is poised and ready. Michael Thomas slow to get up. And off he comes. Nobody home. Michael Thomas rolling out of the way. Marvelous Monty hitting the mat. That's not good for the knees there. Monty able to bounce right back up. Michael Thomas waiting for him. Thomas over to the side. Monty shooting off the ropes. Thomas there. The two men come together and Michael Thomas with the big move, the back body drop. Up goes Monty. Down comes Monty. Michael Thomas definitely advantageous right now.
Well, Michael Thomas is a two-time SLCW men's champion, and not because for any other reason than he's got the tools in the ring to get it, but you got somebody like Marvelous Monty climbing his to count. One, two, no. He misses the real deal. It does the real deal, but misses the pin opportunity. Two count only. Marvelous Monty digging deep down now. Michael Thomas has earned his right to be the SLCW men's champion, and Marvelous Monty wants to knock him off that throne a little bit. Michael's a little bit cocky about it. Calls himself the man.
Well, it's not the first time, though. Michael Thomas has held that title before, if I remember correctly.
That's what I said.
Took it from Sparkles, didn't he?
I don't have that stuff up. Dude, I don't remember what I ate for breakfast. Now, come on.
Marvin was Monty shooting off the rope.
Sure, there was bacon involved.
Monty does a lift. Michael Thomas getting caught by that. Now Monty trying to soften him up. Off the rope one more time. Huge leg drop. He goes for the pin. One, two, and no. You're not going to pin Michael Thomas without grabbing that leg, folks. That's just not going to happen. Love him or hate him, Michael Thomas, like numbers were saying, has definitely earned the right to be in that ring, to wear that belt, and just laying across his body isn't going to get that pin.
Marvelous Monty playing it up now. I don't know. He's in his pajamas telling Michael he's going to get him.
Michael into the rope. Michael shooting back off the ropes. Monty there waiting for him. Monty with the fireman's carry drops Michael Thomas down to the mat. Michael Thomas springing right back up. Monty, I think, wanted a little bit more downtime on that one. However, Michael Thomas had a little bit in mind. Thomas goes back in. Monty catches him. Nice arm drag, and down goes Thomas one more time. Monty showing him and taking him down to the mat anytime he wants. Monty off the ropes, off the top rope, he comes flying in. Monty nailing Michael Thomas one more time. Thomas looking a little bit frustrated as he starts to get up. Monty over in the corner. Monty is up on the top turnbuckle. Michael Thomas slow to get up, looking a little bit wobbly there. Monty is on there, poised and ready. Thomas turning around. Marvelous Monty, I guess he's waiting for him to get in position. Oh, Marvelous Monty going for the giant leap. the YOLO, he gets caught in midair. Michael Thomas power bomb as he lays Monty out. Oh my God, Monty went flying through the air and got caught.
Now, you don't see a guy like Michael power bombing too much, but goddamn, one, two, no, Marvelous Monty somehow gets the shoulders up.
Holy shit, I thought Monty was out cold after that power bomb. I was stunned by the fact that Michael had enough strength in him to catch Monty midair. I mean, that was 200 and some odd pounds of man flying at him in the air, and still Michael Thomas had the strength to catch him. Thomas, the code red! He's got the pin! One, two! Oh my God. Really? Really? I thought for sure after that code red it was all done.
Well, they are 1-1 right now, and next pin is going to win, so this is just like a regular old, good old-fashioned slobber knocker.
The two men standing right there in the center throwing punches. Now it looks like Monty got the worst of it. Michael Thomas off the ropes. Here he comes flying in. Monty catching him in midair. No, he didn't. The Dragon Ring. One, two, and three. Michael Thomas, ladies and gentlemen, still your SSEW men's champion. He takes the win. Marvelous Monty. Getting caught by that Dragon Rana. Oh, my God. What a hell of a move off the rope by Michael Thomas. Executed to perfection. Incredible move, Michael Thomas. Better luck next time, Monty.
I know the score. At the back of my hand. Them other boy. I don't give a damn. They kiss on the ring. I carry the crown. Nothing can break. Nothing can break me down.
Smith out there right now. Her opponent's getting ready to come out at 143 pounds, standing in at 5 feet 8 inches tall from Forest Hills, Queens, New York. she is, Joanne Steele!
DCWF Women's Action from the Women's Division coming to you right now as Joanne Steele takes on Kimberly Smith here at War Games. I'm excited for this. To be honest, I haven't seen a ton of either of these two, and what I've seen has been like completely 100% impressive. So this is their first opportunity to face off against each other in a pay-per-view style match like this. And Lord knows, they're probably going to blow the roof off the place.
Oh, let me tell you, Joanne Steele has, she has become one of the, violent is how I would describe her. She is a no-holds-barred wrestler. She gives no thought to the other wrestler, you know, ending a career. She doesn't care. If she ends somebody's career, that's one less person she has to face in that ring. And let me tell you, every move she does, every time she hits, that's what she's going for. And I am truly concerned for Kimberly Smith. I know Kimberly Smith is a hell of a wrestler. I know she's got what it takes to be in there. But Joanne Steele is going to end her. And I don't think Kimberly Smith...
Are you making predictions? Are you making predictions?
No, that's what she's going for. I am not making a prediction. And now we see the two women locked up in the center of the ring. The bell's been rung. We are underway, ladies and gentlemen. Worried a little bit about Kimberly Smith. She's been taking a lot of punishment to the head and neck. Hope she's a hunter.
This turned it into a fist fight right here in the center of the ring. Both women going for it. Kimberly with a takedown. Hey, by the way, why don't you put a list together of non-violent wrestlers that we have here at the DCW?
You know that's not what I would say in numbers. Not all wrestlers come out here to end another wrestler's career. Meanwhile, Joanne Steele is definitely on the track to do that with Kimberly Smith right now. I mean, everybody's got to be a little violent to get in that ring. Hell, we got to be a little violent.
I was told Spock was pacifist, but other than that, I think.
Conscientious objective, Sparkle? Is that what he is? Kimberly Smith right now taking control of this match, and she has gone in after it. Goes for the pinfall real quick. One. And that's all we're going to get right there.
Kimberly Smith, I don't think you should be worried about her anymore. She understands the situation she's in. She's taking down Joanne Steele, got the first pin in there. I'm pretty sure she's ready to handle whatever. Both of these women are first year, their rookie year here in the DCWF, and in short order, they're kind of mainlining a pay-per-view match right now.
Oh, absolutely, and this is one of the big things for them is rookie versus rookie. And one of the biggest pay-per-views we put on each year. I mean, this is a hell of an introduction to the DCWF for both these women as far as the pay-per-view venue goes. So, big thing here for both of them. I'm sure a lot of nerves on both sides, but after that first punch was thrown, I think all those nerves went away and these two are just going at it. They're scrappers for sure. Joanne Steele, coast to coast, here she comes charging in. Flying into the corner, Kimberly Smith sends inside there. Joanne Steele coming on in, the big stinger splash. Kimberly crumpled in that corner.
Well, but she just bouncing her head off that corner turnbuckle. Then why not? What else are you going to do with a corner turnbuckle? What are they really there for, if not to bounce somebody's head off?
It was there for George Animal Phil to have a little lunch, if you remember. He used to like come in and eat one of those. Am I showing my age there, Numbers?
That's me. What I am.
I figured you were talking about Dusty Rhodes back in the 80s. I could throw a little George the Animal Steel in there, too. Kimberly Smith brought out of that corner the hard way. We got a pin right now. Joanne Steele going for the pin. 1-2, Kimberly Smith. Oh, Joanne picking her up, saying, not done with you yet, Joanne. A little bit more punishment to come for Kimberly.
Now that could come back and bite her in the ass later on down the road. She didn't take her opportunity to get the three count.
It absolutely could. And now, oh, what is that? Joanne Steele, one of the vicious, the desecrator. That'll take the arm completely out of play. And she damn near dislocates Kimberly's elbow and shoulder with that desecrator. Looking for the pin one more time. 1-2, Joanne Steele rolling her up. No, Kimberly with the kick out.
So what do you think of our Detroit replica here?
Man, I am loving this. Motor City never looked better.
Huh?
Oh, I imagine how Motor City looks most of the time, so I was trying to give him a compliment.
Oh, we done made a fan mad.
All right, roll up pin right there. Here we go. 1-2. That's okay. Samantha Fox is going to handle it for me. She's going to give out some huggers and make it all better.
Yeah, referee, yeah, I don't know why people are arguing with Taylor. Taylor's on point each and every match she refs all the time, and they're always trying to say, oh, your count's too fast, your count was too slow, you know.
I tell you, Taylor's a fairly impressive referee. I mean, she is usually right on top of it. As soon as the pin happens, she's dropping and slapping that mat. So it's not like they really have a whole lot to complain about with Taylor. I guess some people want it to hurry up. Some people don't like how fast it counts. I don't know. I think Taylor does a really good job keeping it nice and even there.
There you go. The crowd's finally giving some love to the ref.
Joanne still up behind Kimberly Smith. Kimberly talking to Taylor about something, making sure something's okay right there. And, oh, Joanne still up behind her. The German suplex for the pin. 1-2. And Kimberly able to kick out of it. Kimberly is grabbing her head and her neck. Like we said earlier in the show, she has taken a lot of damage to those 2 points of her body in the last few weeks. I'm seriously wondering if this may not be a hindrance for her. And it seems that Joanne Steele is definitely targeting those areas right now. Joanne gets her up the Death Valley Driver! And she nails it. Kimberly Smith driven into that mat. Joanne Steele showing the viciousness that comes along with fighting against her. Roll up pin. 1-2. And no, Kimberly still able to get her shoulder up. Joanne Steele showing a little frustration, a little expletive right there from her.
She said, fuck.
She did. She said it out loud right there. And now she's over there talking to Taylor, evidently not happy with the count.
Joanne or the Steele language.
Joanne Steele never said it.
What the fuck is this, robber room? Fuck, 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 fuck.
Who's the motherfuckers in there? I didn't hear any motherfuckers from you.
Motherfucker!
And Joanne still arguing with Taylor. Meanwhile, Kimberly is up on her feet, giving a second to catch her breath. Now Joanne turns around. She sees Kimberly up, moving over towards her. Oh, Kimberly sets her up! Did you see that? Kimberly pushing her up into the super kick, the pop-up super kick, and she nailed Joanne Steele with that thing.
Well, now is her chance to capitalize and walk out of here with a win. And don't talk to her, goddamn pitter!
Right? Get on down in there. You done laid her out. Get your ass on top of her. Evidently, she wants to jaw jack a little bit. That's going to come back to bite her in the ass. Joanne Steele up. Kimberly Smith off into the corner. Joanne Steele in the center of the ring. Taylor right on top of everything right now. And Kimberly is up on that rope again. Joanne distracted by the referee. Coming off the top. Here comes the flying. The DLR. She nailed it. Joanne Steele slammed into that mat because she couldn't get her eyes off Taylor. We got a pin attempt. 1, 2. No.
All right, Joanne Steele kicking out of that one. Kimberly, I don't know, she's got anything left to give.
Both wrestlers panning pretty hard. You can definitely see Kimberly up there trying to draw them deep breaths, trying to get it back into her lungs. But man, I think Kimberly may be running out of gas like you're saying.
Well, she done did the pop-up super kick. Pin, another pin attempt.
Now we got the kick to the gut. Oh! The Covent Garden! Roll up pin, here we go. 1, 2, and no! Joanne still, a little bit of resolve, a little bit of resiliency in her right there as the lady is able to kick out. Kimberly Smith looking a little frustrated from that. That Covent Garden usually going to finish the match for this time. Joanne still having no part of that. Kimberly Smith telling Joanne Steele to get up. Kimberly looks like she's over here poised against the rope. Joanne Steele slow to stand up, and here comes Kimberly Smith charging in right behind her. Kimberly Smith in behind her. Oh, Kimberly Smith with the cross rail. Down goes Joanne. Here we go with the pin. 1, 2, and no.
Well, goddamn, it looks like Joanne's kicked out of every finishing move Kimberly's got on it.
Then Kimberly's in a lot of trouble. If her finishers can't put Joanne down, I don't know if she's got much left. And Joanne Steele's going to come back from this. You got to watch her. She is a resilient female. Kimberly off into the ropes one more time. Joanne Steele laid out there on that mat. And she is grabbing her head. She's in a lot of pain. Kimberly waits for her to get up. Taylor's right on top of the action. Kimberly up. Joanne up. Both looking wobbly. Both looking winded. Kick to the gut from Kimberly Smith. What do we got here? Oh, Kimberly Smith, the big tube driver. We got the pin. 1, 2. This should be it. Here we go. And no, Joanne Steele kicks out of the tube driver. The third finisher in a row. Joanne Steele kicks out of that tube driver. Oh, my God. What is this lady on? PCP, the cocaine. I don't know.
I looked up her birthday, and I found out her birthstone was crack rock, and apparently that's what's going on here because she is hopped up and ready to go. Jesus Christ, can't put this girl away.
Holy shit, she kicked out of the tube driver. Nobody kicks out of the tube driver. Joanne Steele does. And now Kimberly Smith is completely winded. Look at her standing there. She can't even catch her breath. Meanwhile, Joanne Steele is back up on her feet. Kimberly could be in a lot of trouble here, folks. Joanne coming up. Looks like she got a heel kick to the gut right there. Taylor looking a little confused as Kimberly Smith goes down really hard from a kick to the gut. Number
Well, that's all it takes sometimes. Little boot to the tummy.
I don't know, maybe it was a little low. Maybe we got the yum-yum kick instead of the gut kick. I don't know there. But that dropped Kimberly pretty hard for a boot to the gut. Then okay, maybe
now, Kimberly
pushed that winded.
No, it looks like she might have kicked her right in the cooch, man. Right. The cooch isn't my word. Cooch is not my word. I do not use that word.
Oh, we got some yum-yum abuse going on in the ring. Oh, Joanne reaching down, picking up Kimberly Smith. Taylor still unsure what happened there. Ah, the cooch. We got the old cooch going on in here today. Joanne still coming off the rope. Kimberly Smith looks like she's being set up. Joanne still off the rope, coming hard. And Joanne still moving in with the... looks like she's got her in the crucifix, maybe? What is that? What do we got? No, we got the... we got her in a submission hold. We can see that. Not exactly sure what Joanne still is calling that, but Kimberly in a lot of trouble. Are we going to see a tap out? Taylor is asking. Kimberly is refusing the tap. Kimberly in a whole lot. She's got the flying dragon on her, and down she goes. Looks like we're moving into that Fujiwara arm bar. Oh, she takes Kimberly down to the mat. Kimberly refusing. Kimberly struggling. This could be it. Looks like Joanne's trying to pop that shoulder right out. Taylor's right on top of her. Taylor asking for it. Kimberly refusing, trying to struggle, trying to get out. Taylor in on the action. She is right there on top of it. Kimberly starting to fade. Joanne's still telling her to give up. Taylor asking if Kimberly's there. Kimberly in so much pain, she's starting to black out. Joanne still cranking that thing in there. And she is about to pop that shoulder out. Look at the leverage she's got on that arm. How much longer can it go on? How much longer will Taylor allow it to go on? Kimberly Smith. No response from Kimberly Smith now. No response at all. Taylor saying she's gone. Taylor saying that is it. We have a cast out wrestler in the ring. Joanne still not letting her go. Taylor has called the match. The bell is rung. Joanne still has won by a submission. Right on top of Kimberly still. Sellers, you told her what would happen. Kimberly Smith out cold in the center of that ring.
Well, Kimberly went out there and did all she had to do, but gave up short.
Dude, she hit three of her partner's finishes in a row and still could not pick the win.
Well, here's how this is going to work. We've done coin tosses in the back. We've done coin toss in the back between the teams, and two members from each team are going to start. And then at 3-minute intervals, we're going to send out somebody else from the next team. And the next team is always the one that won the coin toss. So there'll be an advantage, disadvantage, everything's out. You'll understand once you see the match. Once everybody is in the ring, once everybody is in the cage, the referee will lock the cage, and the match can officially be won, but the match can only be won by submission, by knocking somebody out, or a member of the team throwing in the proverbial towel. Am I clear as mud on this?
Submission. Knock the fuck out or throw in the towel.
Or throw in the damn towel!
There is no count out. There is no pinfall.
There's no shit. Now, Jay Alexander Frost has been running around talking about how great his team is. Him, Sparky, and Crisis versus the team that I put together, the past, the present, and the future. Mythal Wojcik, the DCWF World Heavyweight Champion. James, he needs to go full inmate for this match. James Williams needs to go full inmate for this match, because it's kind of like a prison in there. And of course, but what I say, I said Nick, James, whatever. Let's do this thing. Holy cow, I'm excited.
Well, we need to see James bring it to the yard then. Hey, anything goes inside that cage, right?
Do it.
As long as you knock a motherfucker out.
Let's do it. Let me get my timer going. Hold on. I'm getting my timer going.
You ready? You ready?
I'm doing my timer. You hold on.
I'm holding.
All right, go ahead.
All right. Coming out first. Weighing in at 235 pounds. He stands 6 feet even. He is from Blackpool, England. He is the gorgeous nightmare, Nick Odium! The first opponent from the other side, weighing in at 240 pounds. He stands 6'1" tall, from Frankfurt, Germany, the man, the myth, the legend, Jay Alexander Frost. And when does the 3 minutes start? Numbers.
When the bell rings.
So we have to put up with Jay Alexander Frost coming out and posing and doing all that shit before his time starts. Oh, he's actually going right into the ring. Oh, thank God for small favors right there. Right off the bat, Nick Odium versus Jay Alexander Frost.
All right, and as it were, Jay Alexander Frost's team has won the coin toss in the back. So in 3 minutes, they'll be bringing out their next team member.
Referee just kind of staying out of the way right here. I'm not even sure what his job is in that ring right now, other than text you if somebody got knocked the fuck out.
Or submits, or goes in the towel.
I'm really hoping. I lost my words there for a minute.
Well, look, you know, Jay has come out here and, you know, insulted the crowd, insulted the DCWF roster, insulted just about everybody. Like, Nick Odium is standing up for the fans, and he's standing up for the boys in the back right now.
And he is doing a hell of a job of it right now. Kick to the chest, the rolling soulbutt kick, and damn, he takes Alexander Frost down quickly. The timer is counting down. Nick Odium in there going against Jay Alexander Frost. Nick Odium taking it right to the man, the myth, the legend in his own mind, Jay Alexander Frost. Headbutt driving Jay down to a knee. Jay popping back up. Nick quick with the spinning back kick. Nick showing all that martial arts training that he's got as he just takes it to Jay Alexander, who has taken a beating so far. Standing, shining wizard, and down goes Jay. Maybe Nick's trying to end this son of a bitch right now.
Now we're a minute and 40 left here before before Nick finds himself in a precarious position here.
Nick,
he's gonna have somebody else to contend with. Is Jean-Claude Van Damme spinning kick all the way around there?
He did do that, didn't he? He just did that. He did that spinning kick, showing off a little bit. But maybe he should be staying right on top of Jay Alexander Frost, because like you said, in just about a minute, he's going to be at a disadvantage with two of them in the ring against him for 3 minutes. Nick goes to pick him up. Jace comes up with the eye rake, and now Jay is firing right back. Evidently, he had enough time to catch his breath while Nick was over there showing off. Jay Alexander Frost, a couple of big punches right there. Jay Alexander off the ropes, big drop kick to the face, down goes Nick Odium. Jay Alexander Frost taking advantage of the time that Nick Odium was showing off for the crowd. And now Nick Odium in trouble, and oh, we got less than a minute left before somebody else comes in. Meanwhile, Jay Alexander Frost is taking it straight to Nick, regaining control of this match. Jay Alexander Frost off the ropes, here he comes flying back in. Jay Alexander, leg drop.
Alexander Frost finally fighting back. We've got 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And here he comes, weighing in at 190 pounds. He stands 6 feet tall. Has Nick Odium down on the mat, and he is stomping the crap out of him. Sparkles Von Quinn were coming in, telling everybody to Ken Hutt. Evidently, Sparkles is in military garb today. Not sure what that's all about.
Not war games. Come on now.
I can
appreciate a good Sparky joke from time to time.
And Nick Odium not appreciating anything right now as the two teammates start going at him. Jay Alexander Frost, Sparky Von Quinworth, they have Nick Odium at a definite disadvantage. Jay Alexander moving off to the side, taking a break real quick, going to go ahead and catch his breath, let the fresh man in the ring go ahead and handle up on Nick Odium. Nick Odium's got a long 3 minutes ahead of him as he waits for a teammate to come in and save him. Meanwhile, Sparkles Von Quinworth goes to stomping. He starts taking it to him.
This match hadn't even technically really begun until all men are in the ring. And so Nick's got a long way ahead of him, about a minute and 30 before he sees any kind of relief.
Sparky picking Nick up. Nick digging deep, comes up firing. Wasn't quite enough. Sparky rocked a bit, but he comes back with a couple of vicious chops across the chest. Now Nick trying to fight back. Sparky answering with a super kick. driving Nick back. Nick with the stagger ecstasy answered again by Sparkle super kick. And down goes Nick. The two men trading kicks right there. Yeah,
going
toe-to-toe. That's going to be an interesting one to watch right there. Sparky, of course, one of the best in the business. Sparky with that big knee to the arm, trying to break it. Nick in need of a lot of help right now. Looks like Sparky's setting him up. J. Alexander Frost looks like he's done resting. Sparky DDT. Nick Odom taking the full brunt of that. J. Alexander Frost coming over. The two teammates working in tandem as they go to work again on Nick Odom. Nick needing his second man in there. How long we got?
We got 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, 198 pounds, 6 feet tall, comes from Swansea, Wales. He is the Celtic Dragon, Mitchell Wilson. Man,
yeah, Methel not wasting any time getting into the cage. He is set and ready to go. He's getting in on this. J. Alexander Frost down to meet him. Former three-time ECW World Heavyweight Champion, the Celtic Dragon, in this thing and ready to go.
Nick Odom getting deep, finding a way to fight back. He's got Sparkle down on his knee. Meanwhile, Mitchell Royce set J. Alexander Frost going toe-to-toe right now. No love lost between these two as these two just get going at it. The Celtic Dragon going after J. Alexander Frost. Meanwhile, over here, we got Nick Odom fighting back. Now that it's one-on-one, seems like he's taking care of Sparkle Von Swinworth. Beautiful move right there. Sending Sparky off into the corner. Nick Odom right on top of him. Sparky slams into that corner. Nick following him right in. Meanwhile, you've got Mitchell Royce checked. He's got J. Alexander in that side headlock. Mitchell cranking that thing down hard. Nick Odom right on top of Sparkle's Von Twinworth, getting a chance to do a little fighting back one-on-one here. And that may be a lot of trouble for Sparky.
J. Alexander Frost here taking it to the former three-time DCWF World Heavyweight Champion, looking to gain his place in the annals of DCWF history and work his way up the ladder.
Mitchell Wojcik taking that blow. J. Alexander Frost holding his head. He's in pain. Meanwhile, over in the corner, you see Nick Odom just going to work on Sparkle's Von Twinworth. There's nobody standing there. Count him out, get him out of that corner. So Nick Odom is taking full advantage of that as he is just pounding the shit out of Sparkle's Von Twinworth in that corner, just taking it to him hard. Meanwhile, Mitchell Wojcik has been thrown up into the turnbuckles. J. Alexander Frost on top of him. J. Alexander Frost, couple of punches to the gut. Nick Odom, Sparky locked up right now. J. Alexander Frost still has Mitchell trapped in that corner. Oh, Sparky firing back. Scoop. Slam. Down goes Nick Odom. Over in the corner, J. Alexander Frost has got Mitchell Wojcik, and he is just pounding on his head right now. The good guy's at a disadvantage as they're going to have 3-on-2.
5, 4, 3. 2, 1.
245 pounds. He stands 6 feet 6 inches tall. He comes from Prison City, Michigan, just down the road. He is the Crisis. Mitchell Wojcik fighting back, going off against J. Alexander Frost. Sparkle Von Twinworth has Nick Odom. He was just pounding him into the ground. Now he's going in to work on that arm. And here comes the crisis. Mitchell Wojcik sending Jay Alexander Frost into the ropes. Jake's bringing him back up. Mitchell Wojcik there waiting for him. Mitchell drop kick. Down goes Jay Alexander Frost. Sparkles Von Quinworth. The vertical suplex. Nick Odium in trouble. He has been in the ring the longest. And now we have Jay's entire team in there as the crisis steps in. Nick Odium catches Sparkles Von Quinworth's foot as he goes for a kick. Now Nick Odium, the kneeling ecstasy. Mitchell Wojcik not even paying attention to Jay. Mitchell Wojcik goes straight after the crisis as the crisis comes in. I guess Mitchell hoping to get up on him quick and early, not give the fresh man the chance to take over the ring. Nick Odium fighting back.
Now what the hell is going on here? That's Gina Rose, Jay Alexander's paramour, and she's got chains.
Meanwhile, Jay Alexander Frost is down in between the ropes between the two rings. The crisis turning around. The crisis going back.
Hey, she's chaining up the doors.
She can't do that.
I know she can't do that, but she's chaining up the doors to prevent the DCWF World Heavyweight Champion from being able to get into the ring. And the referee can't do anything about it, can't see it, can't stop it. And the doors are chained up, and we've got a minute and 40 seconds to figure out how to get the damn things off. Somebody call Locksmith!
Meanwhile, back in the ring, we have gone over into two separate rings now. Looks like Mitchell Wojcik being thrown over into the other ring by the crisis. Meanwhile, we've got Sparkles Von Quinworth locked up with Nick Odium. Ladies and gentlemen, pandemonium in the ring and chains on the doors. Looks like the champ is not going to be able to get in here to help his team out. Members, your team's in trouble.
Well, goddamn, they are if that.
Two men working over Mitchell Wojcik right now. Jay Alexander and the crisis on him. Meanwhile, Sparky seems to have his job well in hand as he's taking out Nick Odium.
I mean, usually people are trying to keep James Williams in a cage, but now they're trying to keep him out. Some shenanigans. This must have been planned once they won the coin toss that they were going to lock the cage up.
The good guy's in trouble right now. Jay Alexander Frost, the general of his army, looks like he is directing it just right. Mitchell Wojcik on the mat. Nick Odium on the mat. The crisis over there taking care of business. Now Jay Alexander Frost comes over to check on Sparky, looking for his progress right here. And it looks like Sparky has this well in hand. Sparky's got him up. Vertical suplex. Down goes Nick Odium. Meanwhile, over on the other side.
And we're at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I don't know what the hell is going to happen now.
I'll introduce him, though. Here y'all go. Everybody knows him.
Daddy's home.
Ladies and gentlemen, 359 pounds. He stands 69 inches tall.
He's
from San Rafael, California.
Who the hell else breaks bowl cutters?
He is the DCWF World Heavyweight Champion, James Williams. Nick Odium firing back, ladies and gentlemen, Nick Odium firing back, spinning backwards. He drops Sparky Von Quinworth. Nick Odium finding his reserve. Here he goes. There's the reason he is one of the best ever entering the ring. Nick Odium dropping. Kick DDT. Sparky Von Quinworth in trouble right now as Nick Odium finds that special reserve tank and goes to work on Sparkles. Sparkles thrown into the corner. Nick Odium right on top of him. jawbreaker by Nickodium. Now he's got him hung up. The funky in the tree of war. Nickodium going across the ring. Here we go. Coast to coast. Nick's got him set up. Nick comes sliding in. Dude.
The blue cutter's put to work. James Williams is in the match, and this thing is officially begun.
Running hip attack, and James Williams coming in, going right after Jab. There is definitely no love lost between these two. James Williams cannot stand J. Alexander Frost, and he drops him like a fucking sack of potatoes. Meanwhile, Mitchell Wojcik able to get back on top. The good guys are on it right now. The crisis in trouble. J. Alexander Frost in trouble. And over in the other side, Sparky Vaughn Quinworth being handled up on by Nickodium. Ladies and gentlemen, looks like the good guys, the management team, is on top of it right now. James Williams tossing J. Alexander Frost like he's nothing to him. Mitchell Wojcik, he's got the crisis down. And then, boom, uppercut that European style. Down goes the crisis over in the other ring. Nickodium taking care of Sparky. Sparky firing back. Does it in Zaguri and takes Nickodium down. Uh-oh, Nick may be in a little bit of trouble, ladies and gentlemen. Sparky's got it going on over there. Meanwhile, James Williams switches up, and there goes down the crisis. Now he's got to face off against a big man. Meanwhile, Mitchell Wojcik is all on top of J. Alexander Frost. J. Alexander Frost is definitely not turning out like he had hoped once he put those chains on. Now Jay knows his team's in trouble. Mitchell Wojcik's got J. Alexander Frost in that side headlock. James Williams standing over the crisis. Meanwhile, over in the other side, Nickodium in a lot of trouble. Sparkles Vaughn Quinworth trying to regain control over there. James Williams reaching down, picking up Rob Crisis, the Crisis. And now Mitchell Wojcik, it looked like Jay tried to get him in a hammerlock. Mitchell Wojcik elbowed him in the face, reversed the hammerlock, and oh! Dropped right on the arm. J. Alexander Frost in trouble. The Crisis thrown into the corner. Big splash by James Williams, and down goes the Crisis.
The Crisis is kind of the wild card in this match. Not really an official member of the DCWF roster, but obviously he was picked for this team on War Games. He did some stuff at a cross brand with WPWF and DCWF. So, you know, so clearly he's under contract here in some way, shape, or form. But he's the wild card in this match. You don't know a lot about him. You don't know what he can do, what he's going to do. And right now he's contending with the DCWF Heavyweight Champion. But the tables can turn on James Williams in a heartbeat.
J. Alexander Frost punching Mitchell Wojcik back into that corner. The doors have been locked by the referee. This cage is shut. And y'all heard it. Knock the fuck out. Submission. Throwing in the towel. And what was the other way? That was it, right?
Knocked out, though. And yeah, how many times have I got to explain it to you, man?
I'm stuck on knock the fuck out. You know that. Nickodium sparkles in a headlock. Nickodium starts dragging him back over into the corner. Meanwhile, in the other ring, oh, Mitchell Wojcik brought out of the corner the hard way. J. Alexander Frost firing back. Meanwhile, over in the other corner, you got James Williams up on Rob Crisis. Rob Crisis trying to fight his way out of that corner, wanting to get the big guy off of him. Nickodium doing the sexy dance. Nickodium did the electrifier. Sparkles Vaughn Quinworth caught all of it, and now Nickodium is over there dancing all sexy for him. The sexy nightmare. This could spell it for Sparkles Vaughn Quinworth, coast to coast. Nickodium comes flying across. Nickodium balls to the face. Sparky goes down. James Williams sends the Crisis off into the ropes. Meanwhile, Mitchell Wojcik off the ropes himself. Huge split leg moonsault as he nails J. Alexander Frost with that. Oh, the Crisis comes flying off the ropes, and James Williams not ready for that one. The Crisis coming in. The outbreak lariat, and down goes James Williams. Meanwhile, Mitchell Wojcik is taking care of J. Alexander Frost the only way he knows how, and that is hard. Right now, Nickodium looks like he's got Sparky. Oh, Jimmy Trotter coming over to this side, checking on Sparky. Do we have a knock the fuck out? standing corkscrew moonsault from Nick Odium. Jay Alexander, Sparky in a lot of trouble. I don't know, Nick's going for a pin. I don't think that's the way you can win in here. Better let that go, Nick.
Well, shit. In the heat of battle, you do some stuff sometimes. Like, this is war games, man.
Okay.
Like, I ain't mad at it. If any guy in the other match, he just been Sparky. So, moral victories. Moral victory. Well, for him.
Jay Alexander Frost. Oh, he's got Mr. Wojciech up and down. The Alabama slam, Mr. Wojciech going out right there. Meanwhile, the Crisis and James William are going at it. Jay Alexander Frost right on top of Mr. Wojciech, and he is pounding the shit out of him in that match. Meanwhile, it looks like James William and Rob Crisis have separated, both in opposite corners right now, trying to catch a little breath on both sides. Mr. Wojciech in a lot of trouble out in the other side. Got Nick Odium with Sparkles Von Quinworth. Oh, what is Sparky grabbing? Sparky with... What's that on Sparky's hand? What is that? What's that on Sparky's hand? Is that allowed?
Nope.
Sparky with a little bit of contraband in there. Hope he doesn't get caught. James Williams over on top of the Crisis. And he's got him down on the mat. Meanwhile, Jay Alexander Frost is taking control of his opponent. Mitchell Wojciech laid out on the mat right now. Jay Alexander Frost trying to plan out the next move right here, trying to figure out how to win this match for his team.
Sparky with them knuckles, using them knuckles, and Jimmy Trotter on the, in the other ring covering most. Hell, it's war game.
It's war game. Looks like Nick Odium tried to come back with a discus punch right there. It looks like he caught Sparky. So maybe the knuckles not actually doing it as well as Sparky would have liked. Mitchell Wojciech now back up fighting against the Alexander Frost. Couple of kicks to the gut right there. European uppercut one more time. There's a little introduction to the EU for you there, Jay Alexander Frost. Rob the Crisis over there in the corner. James Williams right on top of him. James brings him out of the corner the hard way. Big power slam right there. Sparky going for the super kick. And Nick Odium responding with a spinning back fist. Both men laid out on the mat in the other ring. I don't know if either one of them are conscious. Yep, looks like one of them's moving. Sparky's moving first. James Williams over here. He's got the Crisis in the corner. Meanwhile, the Alexander Frost is on top of Mitchell Wojciech. Jay Alexander Frost up on a knee while Mitchell is still writhing in pain on the mat. Camera's trying to capture it all. Look at Nick Odium, Sparkles, Von Quinworth. Nothing going over on in that ring. Both of those men taking a little nap right now, trying to catch their breath, maybe recuperate a little bit. Both of them have been in the ring quite a while. Mitchell Wojciech down. Jay Alexander Frost stomping the stuffing out of Mitchell. Oh, Rob Crisis fighting back. Rob Crisis, the jawbreaker, and he nails James Williams with that. The big man toppled. Mitchell Wojciech back up as Jay Alexander picks him up. Oh, Mitchell Wojciech, the psycho driver. He nails Jay Alexander Frost with that one. Jay Alexander Frost paying for it. Right now, as Mitchell Wojciech nails him. Meanwhile, Rob Crisis right on top of James Williams after having hit that jawbreaker. Oh, Mitchell breaks off from Jay. He's going to go help the champ out. Mitchell with a kick to the gut. Rob Crisis doubling over. What's going on in the other ring? Those two men still passed out, still taking nighty night time. Mitchell Wojciech going after the Crisis, trying to help his champ out. Bob J. Alexander Frost has been taken out of the equation for the moment. Oh, Rob Crisis looks like he's in trouble. The Dragon Sleeper. The Body Lock Dragon Sleeper. It looks like we might have a submission here. Have we got it? Jimmy Trotter is there checking on it. Rob, the Crisis in trouble. Sparky is up. Nick is still down. Sparky is up. Jay Alexander Frost is up. James Williams down. Mitchell Wojcik has that big dragon sleeper locked in on the Crisis. Jay Alexander Frost just abandoned his teammate right there as he comes over to this other side. Nick Odium being checked on by Trotter right there. Jay Alexander Frost. Jay Alexander saying Nick is out like a light. Trotter checking on him. Is it true? Is Nick out like a light? Jimmy Trotter saying he's out. We got our knock the fuck out, it appears.
Jay Alexander Frost able to distract the referee from the submission hold that was going on. As soon as the referee is distracted, it turns his back. Crisis starts tapping, but he goes over and calls the knockout from the breath. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this match of the War Game for the men's side is going to be the team of Jay Alexander Frost, Sparkles Vaughn Quinworth, and the Crisis. Even though there was a tap out. Even though there was a tap out.
We won. Numbers. Fuck you.
Did he just come spit on you?
Ten hut.
Oh no, fuck. No.
Get out of here.
Well, by hook or crook, the team of Jay Alexander Frost has won.
Oh, that was definitely by crook.
Rob Crisis was forced to tap out, but the referee never saw it. And as we keep saying, if the referee didn't see it, it didn't happen. Well, a bit of a disappointing finish there, Numbers.
Well, like I said, we settle our business in the ring, and you know, some days you get it, some days you don't.
All right, I think that will bring us up to the final match of the evening.
Well, what I know is that Kristen and Gina are going to be ringside to watch their teams.
So, as opposed to Jay, who was in there fighting with his men.
Oh, yeah, they're not going to get involved in this.
They're not going to get involved. Well, should we go ahead and get this show on the road? You think the ladies are ready back there?
Oh, here they come. Here comes Gina. Here comes Kristen at ringside to coach their teams.
The two opposing captains now at ringside, so I guess that means we're about ready to go ahead and call them out.
Do it.
All right, we're going to get our first contestant out. At a height of 5'7" tall, weighing in at 132 pounds, she hails from Vienna, Austria. She is Lyria Gruber! side, her opponent from Rome, Maine, in the U.S. of A., standing in at 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in 161 pounds. She likes to be known as the 21st Century Gladiator. She is Bellona! Ooh, she is a vicious one, number.
She's a little bit mean, yeah.
Alright, we gotta go ahead and keep them bolt cutters out here in case there's any more shenanigans going on.
Shit, I don't know.
We got the two. We got the two ladies in the ring. These are our starting warriors right now. Lyria Gruber, Bellona, the 21st Century Gladiator. And it looks like Jimmy Trotter is ready to get them going. All right, he has called it. Bell has rung. The match has started. They go in, lock up in the center of the ring right off the bat. Lyria Gruber giving up a bit of size to Bellona. Bellona pushing Gruber back into the corner. A little bit of locking up right there. A little bit of jockeying for position as they push him back into the corner. Lyria Gruber up against the turnbuckle right there. And Lyria Gruber taking a couple of knees to the gut right there from Bellona to start this match off with. And Bellona wasting no time to show why she is known as one of the most vicious women in the ring as she goes to pounding that head into the turnbuckle.
Well, Lyria able to take punishment, Bellona able to dish it out. So, you know, in the first 3 minutes of this match here, we could absolutely see some stuff.
That almost sounds like a BDSM thing right there. We got the masochist and the sadist right there. I'm just saying, you got one that likes to take punishment, the other one likes to give it.
What's wrong with you?
I'm just telling you, I kind of know that kind of stuff. All right, Lyria Gruber, not going to be fooled that time. She goes up on that top turnbuckle. She comes off with a tornado DDT. Bellona caught off guard, the Gladiator right down. And Lyria Gruber shows why she belongs in that ring.
Lyria Gruber on the offensive now, and she takes it to Bellona. They're in this cage, and a cage can be used as a weapon.
Right across into that corner, Lyria Gruber quick to follow her in. Stinger splash, she catches Bellona full tilt on that one. Bellona in trouble now. Lyria Gruber front face lock, yanking Bellona back out of that corner. Lyria Gruber got her locked into that front face lock. How long we got, numbers?
We got some time yet as these two are... Oh, and an Irish whip. Lyria Gruber finding herself in trouble again. Bellona with that arm gear on. That probably doesn't tickle.
Probably not. And right now, Lyria Gruber finds herself on the receiving end of the Gladiator's punishment. Lyria Gruber in that corner. Oh, the Gladiator coming in with a big corner splash. Lyria Gruber just kind of falls flat on her face. Bellona picking her up. Snake eyes. That'll end up your eyeballs. That's no good.
And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hailing out of Vancouver, British Columbia, weighing in 135 pounds. She stands 5 foot 7 inches tall. You all know her. She is the dancing darling, Erie!
Brooke Owens! The Black!
What? Look out, man. I'm so sorry. I was thinking the wrong person. You got it right. My apologies. Let me go ahead and introduce her from Orlando, Florida. 5'6", weighed at 135 pounds. The Black Swan, Brooke Owen, man.
Gina's team, just like Jay's team, won the coin toss in the back. I think they were using a two-headed coin.
That is my fault, folks. My bad. I apologize for that. I get so excited on these matches trying to keep up with them. The Black Swan came out next, and now Lyria is in trouble. She's got 3 minutes of fighting off two of the hardest hitting females.
Like, I don't know what you're talking about. This guy over here.
Brooke Owens and Bologna on Lyria. Lyria in so much trouble. 3 minutes of nothing but punishment coming from these two right now. I hope Lyria is able to dig deep. I hope she's able to find a way to get this done and stay in there. Wait for her teammate to come in and rescue her.
All right, and you know, but just so we're clear, the men's match was a 3-on-3, and if you thought that was chaotic, this match is a 4-on-4.
There's going to be a lot of action in both rings. Lyria Gruber taking the punishment right now. Bologna standing on her, the foot choke after a vicious stomp. Brooke Owens picks up Lyria, goes for the choke. Lyria pushing her back. Answer with a super kick. That knocks Brooke Owens down. Bologna can't believe it. Bologna off the rope. She's going to go and show some punishment. No, Lyria waiting for another super kick. And down goes Bologna. Bologna went for that spear, trying to use that shoulder plate. And Lyria was having none of that. Nice super kick as she caught her. And now Lyria fighting back against both of them. Lyria trying to show up.
Bologna's like a more feminine version of the Legion of Doom.
I guess you could call her feminine. Brooke Owens in trouble right now as Lyria bends down, grabs her, picks her up. Bologna off over to the side here. She is up on these ropes. Bologna comes over. She comes in to save her teammate. Bologna finally gets that spear in with that shoulder armor, and down goes Lyria as she takes the impact from that spear shoulder. Shoulder spear? Spear shoulder? Something like that with that shoulder armor. Bologna up behind Lyria. She picked her up. She got her by the hair. She got her set up. Brooke Owens there. Teammate working with teammate. Brooke Owens comes
10,
in.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This,
all right,
now
right.
You can call her.
Now I get to call her at 135 pounds at a height of 5 feet 7 inches tall from Vancouver, British Columbia. She is the dancing darling, Erie
Montin.
Coming in and making a statement right off the bat as she takes out Bologna. Down goes Brooke Owens. Lyria coming in. She is cleaning house and she comes in like a freaking tornado in a trailer park in Texas. She comes right on in and just starts clearing that house. Bologna down. Brooke Owens down. Bodies everywhere. Pandemonium in the ring. And Erie, the dancing darling, taking care of business, giving Lyria a chance to come on back.
And now we can officially say that Erie and Brooke look nothing like each other.
nothing, absolutely nothing like each other. Music not the same, not even close. It could be that I'm a full-on dumbass. Who knows? Either way, we got four women in the ring. Erie going off against Brooke Owens. Bologna facing off against Lyria. And folks, we have serious action in here. Y'all know these women do not play. Erie the Dancing Darling, the one-time heavyweight champion in the BCWF, and taking it to Brooke Owens, the Fallen Angel. Down she goes, or the Black Swan, sorry.
I hope you meant women's champion.
Isn't that what I said?
You said heavyweight.
Oh, my bad. Women's champion.
I mean, she's got some muscles on her, but...
No, she is definitely not the heavyweight champion. Bologna, kick to the gut. Lyria doubled over. Bologna's got Lyria in that corner. She is dishing out the punishment right now. Lyria trying to fight back. Meanwhile, Erie taking care against Brooke Owens. Oh, Erie, the Indian Deathlock. No way to stop that one, folks. We may see a submission here. Meanwhile, Bologna and Lyria going at it. Lyria's got that mandible claw lock. You haven't seen that in a long time.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right, out of Salem, Massachusetts, weighing in at 140 pounds, standing in at 5 feet 10 inches tall, she is the Nightbreed, Regan Blair.
Go get him, Regan.
Regan Blair in now on the side right there. She's taking stock of what's going on.
You know, I can't really talk shit here. Gina put together one hell of a vicious team on the women's side.
Oh, she found the hardest hitting, the meanest, the evilest women she could find, and she put them together as one and turned them loose. Bologna down, Lyria down, Brooke Owens down after being in that Indian Deathlock for what seemed like forever. Now Regan Blair facing up against Erie. Brooke trying to favor that leg, trying to get that numbness out of it, trying to bring some life back into that leg after Erie so wickedly abused it. Meanwhile, Bologna slowly getting to her knees. Lyria still looks like she's a little bit out of it. Facing off against Erie, Regan Blair, the two trading blows. Erie with a big headbutt. Regan staggering back and then coming back in with their own headbutt. Bologna up. Looks like Lyria is crawling away from her, getting over into the clear ring.
Regan, gorilla press her.
Gina calling out orders. Regan given the gorilla press slam as instructed.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
5 feet 4 inches tall, 104 pounds, hailing from Baltimore, Maryland in the US of A. She is the artist to the stars, Calico!
Calico making her return to the DCWF Women's Division in-ring competition right here at War Games. As somehow, someway, Kristen was able to make the right phone call at the right time and put Calico on her team. Calico is as vicious and nasty and is, I don't want to talk bad. She's a nice girl, but when she gets in this ring, she's as mean a competitor as they come. It's a hell of a pick.
Meanwhile, Lyria back at the mercy of both Brooke Owens and Bologna, the Black Swan, the Gladiator, both of them going off on Lyria. Lyria in a whole lot of trouble. She is being left alone. Meanwhile, over here, we've got Erie We've got Calico. We've got a Regan Blair who has been blasted by both of them, laid out on the mat. And
again,
now Erie and Calico coming over into the other ring. She's going to give, they're going to give a little bit of help to Lyria. Bologna laid out. Brooke Owens laid out. Calico Erie coming to the rescue of their teammate. Lyria needing some time. She's been in since the beginning of this. Needing some time to catch her breath. Maybe a little bit of chance to get a little bit of rest here so she can freshen up. Lyria crawling away. She's over to the rope. She's off trying to go ahead and get her breath back. Meanwhile, Regan Blair all alone in this other ring coming up to her knees. Lyria leaning up against those turnbuckles. Erie going after Brooke Owens. Calico going after Bologna. And it looks like they've got them pretty much well in hand. Bologna in a front face lock by Calico. Erie dragging Brooke Owens over towards the rope. Erie wasn't always the sweet, nice dancing darling. Erie has a little dark side to her. We may see it come out right here as she's got Brooke Owens by herself over in that ring.
Look, I've been there since the very beginning, with some of these ladies, with some like, with some like Erie, who, they were kind of raised to DCWF, and they understand this match and what this match means, and what a victory in this match means. And certainly, Gina and Kristen went through, the women's roster from day one to 12 years later to come up with the best teams they possibly could. And this main event might be the War Games match of all War Games match. We may never be able to top this again.
And just think, y'all are here to see it right here. Regan Blair fighting off against Lyria. Bologna, Brooke Owens down on the mat, Calico up. Everybody in one ring. And we still got people to bring out, don't we?
Time.
I'm only counting six.
All things in good time, my friend.
Bologna, Brooke Owens have cleared the other ring right now. That leaves Regan Blair facing off against Lyria, Erie, and Calico. Bologna, Brooke Owens abandoning their teammate. Regan Blair alone by herself facing off against three of the most dangerous women in the DCWF. Erie showing her a little what's what. Calico coming up. Beautiful reverse Rana. We got some high-fiving going on between Erie and Calico. Regan Blair looks like she is out. I don't know. Lyria. Oh, what
well,
we got?
Here
some...
we go. Oh, shit.
Coming in at 120 pounds, 75 feet 5 inches tall. She hails from the Dark Realm. She is the Fallen Knight. Bayman Lewin! Calico quick to come face off against Bologna. Brooke Owens going after Erie. Those two are facing off. Meanwhile, in the other ring, we see Regan Blair and Lyria going at it. Regan Blair, Lyria facing off against each other. And now we've got a little bit of an odd match. We got Phelan Lewin coming in, and she goes directly after Erie. Going to give Brooke Owens a hand. Phelan sending Erie off into the corner. Erie slammed up against the turnbuckle. Phelan staying right on top of her. Big move as she comes in with that corner combination. The elbow, the enziguri, and down goes Erie. Meanwhile, Brooke Owens was coming in. However, Calico, woo! Calico catching Brooke Owens from behind. Reverse Rana. Brooke Owens down hard. Calico coming in to save her teammate. Phelan turning around, taking a couple of boots to the face. There's a little leather for you in the mouth. Phelan Lewin, Erie able to get out of there. Brooke Owens down. Calico rescuing Erie. Bologna down over on the other side. Regan Blair, Lyria rolling around on the mat. The two just going at a cat fight definitely going on that side. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a hell of a match going on right here. It is total chaos in this ring. I don't know how anybody can keep up with this. Erie, Calico standing over Brooke Owens, Phelan Lewin. Looks like we got Bologna back up on her feet. Erie Calico looking like they got something planned. Calico bending down, picking up Brooke Owens. Brooke Owens in trouble. Oh, Brooke Owens thrown into the corner, slamming up against Phelan Lewin. The Dark Swan.
Lyria with the airplane spin. I'm getting dizzy watching that. Oh!
Erie coming in. Big corner splash. There's both of them. Uh-oh, up behind her. Oh, no! Calico took her eyes off Bologna. Bologna came in behind her, got the bulldog down.
And
there's 10, Calico.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Big Sky Twister press from Lyria. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the last competitor. 8 stone, 9 pounds. A height of 5 feet 6 inches tall, coming in from Coventry, West Midlands, England. She is classically trained horses. For Sia, now we have all women accounted for, and oh my God, the ring is going to explode with everything going on inside it. Horses on Bologna. Erie over on the road. Brooke Owens, Phelan Lewin down in the corner. Calico down in the middle. Bologna facing off against Horses Morrissey. Regan Blair, Lyria over there, they're down. Lyria, the huge, freaking beautiful high-flying maneuver. To catch Regan, it was gorgeous. Horses Morrissey, Bologna right there, facing off against one another. Phelan coming after Calico. Calico not having any part of that. Calico fighting back. Now, what the hell is going on? Phelan's got Calico in that Indian death lock. Calico in a lot of trouble. We saw that earlier as Erie right this moment. And Brooke Owens' big set of knee lifts right into Erie's face. Erie taking that punishment right there. Meanwhile, Bologna, Horses Morrissey still facing off against one another. Hit Horses Morrissey, definitely a champion of champions. Need to know, get the book, Horses on Horses. We sell it, all 9,560 chapters of it. Lyria, Regan Blair, they are fighting it up right now. They are locked up over in that upper ring. Those two are going at it. Do we have a submission? It looks like we might got a submission over there, but the referee has no idea that that's going on. Meanwhile, back in the other ring, Erie has taken control. She is beating down on Brooke Owens. Bologna takes Horses Morrissey down now. Phelan, she's got Calico by the throat. She is choking her out. Bologna on top of Horses. She is just pounding into her. The only one standing over here that's on the good side is going to be Erie.
And now what? And now Gina attacking Kristen on the out. Why in the world is this even necessary? Unbelievable now. Gina's already inserting herself way too much into the situation, knocking the doors during the men's match, and now she's basically putting the screws to Kristen here on the outside of the cage. We got no padding. We got nothing but cage and cement. Unbelievable.
All right, and fuck you very much, Firestorm. Sorry about that, ladies and gents.
Gina's attacked Kristen on the... Oh, Kristen fighting back with a super kick.
What am I missing? Christian and Gina going at it? I didn't know they were part of this match.
Well, they're not, but I guess they are.
You know, Gina Rose has attacked Christian a couple of times.
Now, Gina, I don't know. I don't know what her issue with Christian is. I don't know what, you know, what kind of beef she thinks she's got there. And there's nothing anybody can do about it. I mean, it's going to happen. The referee, you know, anybody to be able to pull this one apart is in the inside of the cage anyway.
Well, there is you.
They never pull apart a good cat fight, bro.
Why does that not surprise me, boss?
I'm all a right, flat bush, man. We stay out of that shit.
In the ring, they got it going on. Outside the ring, we got it going on. It is pandemonium. It is cat fights everywhere. It is woman versus woman, and damn, they are vicious. The Coventry Plunge by Horses Morrissey.
Amelia Stock and Reagan, so much action going on in this ring. Fela and Calico, Jimmy Trotter's got the best seat in the house, and I'm not sure he wants it.
I'll get back to calling as soon as I got something more than body parts on my screen. Looks like Lyria and Reagan Blair are still going at it. Reagan, drop toe hold. Phelan.
Oh, now Gina just acted like she didn't get super kicked.
Bologna down, Erie down. What the hell is going on, folks?
Reagan, destroy her.
She sounds a lot like my GPS.
Right? Doesn't seem to be a whole lot of, I don't know, excitement in that as she's talking.
Members, get some new earrings.
Like she's got nothing invested in this match at all. She's like,
watch your dirty mouth. She's got a lot invested here. She put this team together, and JC already won. If her team wins, they're going to throw it in my face, so I'm going to have to listen to it forever. Unfortunately, you know, come paycheck signing day, my pin hand might have carpal tunnel. I don't know.
Bologna taking Horses Morrissey down. Brooke Owens off the ropes. Here she comes flying in. Big kick, the rocket kick. Calico rolls out of the way. Brooke Owens nailing Phelan Lewin with a big rocket kick. Meanwhile, Erie's over in the corner trying to catch her breath. And still, we have Lyria and Regan Blair still going at it. Lyria is beating the crap out of Regan Blair. Good job, Lyria, over there. Those two have been going at it like everybody decided to leave them alone and let them have their own ring all to themselves. Bologna, big chops across Horses Morrissey's chest. Brooke Owens shoving Phelan Lewin back. It looks like Phelan and Brooke have turned on each other. After Brooke made the mistake, Phelan and Brooke are going after each other right now. Meanwhile, Calico and Erie over there taking a rest as they're watching Lyria handle up on Regan. Phelan, Brooke doing their work for them. Bologna, Horses Morrissey still going at it. Phelan and Brooke, no holds barred. These two don't even give a damn. They are both going after it. Meanwhile, both Calico and Erie have gone over, and they've gone after Regan Blair. Regan in a lot of trouble. Phelan, Brooke still fighting. And boy, those two are vicious, and they are after each other. Same team or not, both women pissed off at one another. Leg lariat. Down goes Brooke Owens. Phelan, so cool. So mean, so hard-hitting. Bologna up on the rope. Horses Morrissey.
Calico and Erie. Got
Horses on the rope. Bologna up. Horses flying off the rope. Here she comes. Double axe handle. And she nailed Bologna on top of the hill.
Calico. Calico and Erie have Regan in a double submission move over in the other ring. Nearly is helpless to do anything about it. And it looks like we have the tap.
Oh, and she is tapping the hell out of it, too. Those two beautiful women over there on Regan Blair, the viciousness as both of them put her in that submission hold. Holy crap. Calico, Erie, taking it to Regan right there with that double submission hold. Brooke Owens failing, still not stopping.
This one's over. We're waiting on the official word from the referee, but my God, I haven't seen anything like this in a long time here in the DCWF.
The teamwork, the timing, the way Calico and Erie worked together, this entire match, you would think these two have been partners for a long time. Those two got after it, and once they got on Regan Blair, they were like dogs on a bone, and there was nothing Regan was going to be able to do. That double submission hold, all Regan could do was tap out.
Kristen's team wins this War Games main event, but the action's still going on as Brooke and Phelan have not stopped yet.
Gina's team, I mean, she put together one of the hardest hitting, one of the coolest, one of the evilest women's teams I've ever seen. However, it was just moments before it exploded. We had to know this was coming. Phelan and Brooke going at it, two of the biggest egos, two of the people that are, I mean, they're both trying to climb the ladder right now. And her team imploded.
The oil stopped working in that machine. And I guess Kristen gets the new crown for picking a winning team, man.
I'm happy. I'm fucking ecstatic. Let me just say it. The good guys won, Numbers. The good guys won.
Girls.
Okay, yes. The good girls won.
Oh, I like the bad girls so much more.
I mean, honestly, Monty lost, I was rooting for him. Kimberly lost, I was rooting for her. Jane, Mitchell, and Nick lost, I was rooting for them. So this is a good thing. We finally got a win, number. Just left Brooke laying there. We're so close
to something that it's
Bologna finishing off with a couple of neck breakers as Horses Morrissey is left on the mat. Holy shit. I'm breathless. I am breathless. I'm out of breath. That was incredible.
Well, folks, that puts another War Games in the books. Congratulations to Kristen's team. I got nothing. Wow. As it were, DCWF is going to be taking a week off. We will be back in 2 weeks at the DCWF Arena for DCWF Showdown, and I will have a special announcement about our December pay-per-view.